Hi guys! Welcome back to Glitter and Nom Nom. I'm Annette if you are new here. Today is a random middle of the week video because I got my SOES box. So if you missed last month's video, I will link that down below, probably put it up here too. Go check that out, we got some awesome stuff, and as it stands right now, this box has a 5 out of 5 potato rating. So let's get right into it. The first few things in here, I'm probably going to be giving to my mom or a friend who I know will use it, just because I have a lot of this stuff on my own already and I don't really need more. The first few things we have a Bella Pierre Precious Diamonds nail set, and the first thing in here is a hand and body lotion. It is infused with natural botanical extracts and essential oils. There's not really much of a smell to it. It actually kind of smells like, it's a really mild scent. Like, it's kind of just a basic lotion smell, but it feels really nice. The next thing we have is a nail buffer, and this is one of those dual-sided ones that goes in steps. For people who don't really wear nail polish, and this is one of the ones that leaves your natural nail like extra smooth and shiny, so that it almost kind of looks like you have a clear coat or gel overlay on, and it makes your natural nails look really, really pretty, but I only wear gels, so this doesn't really help me, so I will give it to somebody that it will help. And then along with that, there's also a nail file. And the last thing in the nail kit is a cuticle treatment. I really like this bottle and I always need more cuticle oil, so there's that. Next, I'm very excited about this because I'm going to be doing a long-term review of this. And when this first came out, I desperately wanted it, but could not really afford to spend the money on it if I didn't know it was gonna work or not. The Teeth Whitening Beauty Cocoa. This is the charcoal toothpaste. A little lift seal here. And it's got the charcoal in it. Of course it does, it's the container for the charcoal. The container has the charcoal in it, duh. With that, they sent a Beauty Cocoa Smile Bamboo Toothbrush. And the bristles of this are also infused with charcoal. This is the toothbrush, and that's the head. So these bristles have charcoal infused in them. From what I've seen in other reviews, basically by the end of it, this toothbrush is so gnarly looking. And the last thing we have in here, a Bella Pierre Cosmetics eyeshadow palette, and this is the natural tone palette. It is so I've already kind of played around with it a little bit because I couldn't not. It comes with a little brush here, and this brush is actually pretty good quality. I ripped the sponge head off of the end already. This is the palette, and it looks so beautiful. It's got a cute little mirror right there. Yeah, it's so pretty. I have not tried any of their eyeshadows. I know they have a wide selection of loose shadows. But I don't like loose pigments, so... Oh, it actually has the names! I didn't see that. It has the names of the colors on the back. Top to bottom, it goes left to right. Cute! That was everything in the SOES box. To do a quick recap of the box, they ship out of Florida. It is $13.99, I believe, a month for the subscription. It's a little more if you're in Canada, because the shipping is more. You get between 4 and 7 full-size products, depending on the month. And they seem to be very good brands, but a lot of them I think are less known brand. Ones that you don't really just, like, you can't walk into a Sephora and get. And that's one of the things that I was kind of drawn to about this box, is it's stuff that I wouldn't be going out of my way to look for, and that I can't just go to a store to get, so this stuff is just kind of coming to my door and it's pretty nice. So I'm just gonna do an eye look with this palette, since a lot of this stuff is either going to someone else or is tooth related. I'll be doing another video on that. Let's get this on my face. Winston came to say hi. He's using me to look out the window right now. And also licking the makeup off my hand. He doesn't care. Hey, hi. Hey! So I threw some tape on because I'm not really sure what I'm going to be doing yet or how these pigments are going to turn out. I'm going to start by going into this first matte white shade here called Frost. And I'm gonna use that to set my lids because I got some concealer on here. And there is little to no kickback on this. Now, I'm gonna take a contour brush. This is my Visanti. I'm gonna go into the next shade called Sorbet. It is a matte pink as my first transition. That is nice. I don't know how well you guys can see that with my lighting right now, but it is this beautiful dusty pink. Nice. Now I'm gonna take the darker matte pink called Femme, and I'm gonna put this more just in the outer corner. I kinda wanna play around with these purples. I'm gonna take this shade right here. It's called Intrigue. I wanna see how it goes on the lid with a dry brush. That's there. These are blending super nice. I'm gonna go in with my finger just to see if we can amp this up a little bit. That is just nice. I like this. It's not coming off as dark as it is in the pan, but I'm still happy. Next, I'm going to go into, let's see how. This one is called Utopia. It's a lighter version of the one I just put on, and let's see what the color difference is. I feel like this color is going on more true to the pan, whereas the darker one went on a little bit lighter, so there is a visible difference, but it's not as dramatic as you'd think looking at them side by side in the pan. Now, I'm gonna take the brush they gave me. I'm going to go into this really dark shade here called Dagger. I'm gonna run this on my lash line like liner. I don't know if it's the brush or not, but this isn't working. So I'm gonna try an angled brush. So now I kinda wanna take, I wanna take this gold shade and I'm gonna just use an e.l.f. definer brush. Go into that gold, gold. And I'm gonna put this on my lower lash line. I'm gonna take another little definer brush here and I'm gonna go into the first shimmery pink here called Last Call. And I'm gonna put this one above the eye, just at the brow bone. And actually, I'm gonna take this from the inner corner all the way up to the brow. Mixing it up. Hello! I don't know if you can see how sparkly that is, but it is there. Now I'm just gonna throw some Lash Paradise on and we will discuss. Okay, so this is our finished eye look with the Bella Pierre Naturals palette. I can't see. Ah! So, packaging, presentation, all of that, beautiful, absolutely beautiful. I love how they have the name set up on the back so you can just look right across and know for a fact which names go where. The colors in this palette are absolutely beautiful. Oh, I accidentally chunked into that one. Oops. Blend absolutely beautifully. So beautifully. This was the most effortless I've had to work, especially with pink and purple eyeshadow. Pigmentation is definitely there. Shimmer is for real. The only thing I'd say that's negative about this is probably that not all of these colors, and it appears to be the darker ones, not so much the lighter ones, show up the way you expect them to. And they're still pigmented, don't get me wrong, just they look like a different color slightly. I'm gonna keep playing around with this and I think it's fun and I think it's gorgeous. So I'll have some pictures of this look up on my Instagram. If you have not signed up for this box and you're interested in it, I do have a discount code down in the description box just for you guys. I don't make any commission or anything, it's just there for you. give this video a big I can't talk. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click that bell for the notifications. We'll see you in the next video. I'm back. Sorry. Okay. We will see you in the next video, but this was requested. I'm gonna leave you with some swatches first.